We all reach back into the swirling cloud of memories, and moments reappear, sometimes sharp and sometimes cloaked in fog. But the moment I remember now is a night in March in 1972, a night in Milwaukee, Wisconsin. The noise swirling around us. It was a night of victory that no one outside of the campaign could have imagined, a victory that the establishment could not comprehend. It was as if we had stolen fire. And that night, a reporter asked the then unknown young campaign manager what the secret had been of Senator McGovern's impossible, improbable, and unpredictable upset victory. Gary looked up at him, thought for a moment, and replied, "The truth is, there's less to this campaign than meets the eye." And that reporter probably didn't understand. At that moment, there was plenty that met the eye on the floor of that swirling victory party. But for those few who had been with the campaign, it was true. And what George McGovern worked for and fought for and brought together was instead a small army of people who were there because they wanted this man and this idea to win. Not because they were sure of victory, but because they were sure about what this man stood for and what they stood for. Who knew? No one knew. No? Frank Mankiewicz knew. God knows Washington didn't know. And hundreds of kids across the country who didn't know in their minds knew in their hearts and were changed forever. Living in student dormitories and supporters' homes and on the floors of headquarters and on pizza and on beer and on the energy that only the young can summon impossibly night after night, and the energy of each other and the funny, bright, sarcastic determination that refuses to take anything seriously except the work that we'd set out to do. Those faces and those minds thinking, never giving up on the puzzle of how to transform utterly what was to what could be. And to be given the chance that young people aren't supposed to be given, to just go out and prove everyone wrong, and to never forget how it felt to do that. And then we remember the two calm, reassuring faces that were at the same time strong and gentle. Those two perfect Midwestern faces who started it all by falling in love with each other in a small town in the middle of an American prairie on the eve of a terrible war. Eleanor. That smile said, "I love this man and what he's doing. And yes, I know who I am and where I come from, and I am happier with that than you can imagine." She, we knew, was to be cherished. "Come home, America," was what this remarkable leader told us. And though we are working on that still, it was simply what needed to be said, then as now. And we will not forget that George McGovern was a hero long before he ever ran for president. The years crisscrossing the state in a broken-down car with George Cunningham, building a real Democratic Party where none had really existed before. The Food for Peace program that he forged under President Kennedy. He knew what was possible because he'd done it himself. And he never forgot what raw courage American kids in their 20s are capable of. Sent to war, George McGovern risked his life for something he believed in and saw friends die and never ever forgot them or what was at stake. An anti-war campaign led by a war hero. And George McGovern has been a hero to us ever since. Again, because of actions taken for peace and to feed hungry people around the world. And this is the lesson of that amazing night in Milwaukee. That once unleashed, none of us have forgotten what this man told us to do. And it doesn't matter whether we served as presidents or senators or served people in soup kitchens or raised our children as best we could, or endured tragedies, or filled our hearts with tiny, tiny victories. George McGovern taught us and took a chance on us, and led us, and inspired us, and yes, unleashed us into our lives and into our world. It is a mysterious and courageous thing to set loose a small group of young people and to give them the tools and a mission and a belief in themselves to change the world. So, thank you, dear Senator. And know this, the challenge that you set forth lives on. It has a resilience and power still, a challenge that, at its heart, was always a call to hope and a call to action. Bless your family. Bless you and Eleanor. And God bless America, the land that you loved and defended and challenged to be better and changed forever.